Let's do ABO blood typing. And first we need to see what our experiment is going to involve. And it's going to use 4 trays. And in these trays, we're going to test the blood samples of 4 unknown patients. And so I'll show you those bottles. We have patient number 1, 2, patient number 3, and patient number 4. And each patient is going to have their own tray. And to test these blood samples, we're going to use antibodies. And if you'll recall that antibodies are the little things that are made by the immune system that look like this. They're made by little B cells in the immune system. So an antibody has this little Y figure to it. And I'm going to draw these because I'm going to show you which antibodies we're putting into each of these patients' blood samples. So another thing we need to do is look at the bottle which contains the antibodies. You remember there's an antibody for A, there's one for B, and then there's one against Rh, against rhesus antigen or factor. So these bottles are labeled this way. If you happen to be in lab, you'll see it labeled as anti-A serum. I'm going to make it a little easier for us to recall this, and I'm going to just change the label to A antibodies. And that'll just help you remember that this bottle contains A antibodies. And you know that A antibodies attack red blood cells that have A antigens. Here's anti-B serum. And again, we're going to disguise this label with something perhaps more familiar to you, which is just the word B antibodies. You can call these anti-B, or you can call them just B antibodies. And then we've got anti-Rh serum. And I'm going to cover that label as well, just so that it looks more familiar as Rh antibodies. Right, so we have an antibody for A, an antibody that will attack any red blood cells that have an A antigen. We have antibodies for B, an antibody which will attack any red blood cell that has a B antigen on its surface. And then we have Rh antibodies, which is an antibody that will attack any red blood cell that has the Rh antigen on its surface, meaning that it's positive for Rh, right? So the instructions say, take 1 drop of patient 1 and put that drop in each of these trays, the wells. The wells specify A, B, and Rh. I'm gonna go ahead and do each of the patients. So we're going to do patient number 2. And let's do 3. Just 1 drop into each of the 3 wells for A, B, and Rh. And you can already tell that's where we're going to put the antibodies that match those letters. If you're thinking about this, trying to learn it while we do this, make sure you have your chart or the drawing that you've done for the